We shall move to simple future tense now. Simple future tense is used to denote an action which is going to take place in the future and to promise and to give assurance. We can use simple future tense in our sentence. Verb form for simple future is will or shall plus verb 1. Will or shall plus verb 1. For I and we, we'll use shall plus verb 1, and for he, she, it, for all singular and plural nouns we can use will plus verb 1. Keywords to denote simple future tense are tomorrow, next week, next month and next year. Here are a few example sentences. Shall I collect my books? We shall plan to complete this project successfully. You will come here tomorrow. They will visit Singapore next year. Sumi will play well in the match. These are a few examples to denote simple future tense. Next tenses, future continuous tense. Future continuous tense is used to denote an action which is going to be continuing in the future for a while. Verb form for future continuous tense is will or shall plus be plus verb plus ing. For I and we can use shall plus be plus verb plus ing, and for other subjects like we, you, they, he, she, it, and for singular noun, plural noun, we can use shall plus verb plus ing. Keywords to denote future continuous tense are by this time tomorrow, by this time next week, by this time next month, and by this time next year. These keywords are common for all the three future tenses. They are future continuous, future perfect and future perfect continuous. For all these three also, the same keyword alone will be used according to the action which is denoted there. If it is going to be completed, we will use future perfect. If it is going to be continuing for a long time, we will use future perfect continuous. If it is going to be continuing for a while, we will use future continuous tense. But the keywords are the same for all the three tenses. They are future continuous, future perfect and future perfect continuous. Few examples to denote future continuous tense. I shall be moving to Chennai by this time tomorrow. We shall be watching cricket by this time next month. You will be gathering for your get together by this time next month. They'll be practicing for their annual day by this time next week. These are the examples for future continuous tense. We shall see future perfect tense now. It is used to denote an action that will be completed when two future actions are referred. For the completed one, we will use future perfect tense. Verb form for future perfect tense is will or shall plus have plus V3. Will or shall plus have plus V3. Few examples for future perfect. He will have closed the shop when you go there. For the completed action, future perfect is used. They will have completed their construction work by this time next year. Construction work will have been completed. That's why it is used here. We shall see future perfect continuous tense now. It is used to denote an action that will be completed and will continue in the future for a long time. To denote such an action, we'll use future perfect continuous tense. Verb form for future perfect continuous tense is will or shall plus have plus been plus verb plus ing. Here are a few examples. By the time he leaves the city, he will have been finishing his course. It denotes that an action which will have been completed, at the same time it is about to be continued. To denote such an action, we can use future perfect continuous tense. And in the second example also, by this time next year, he will have been working on a project sincerely. It is going to be continuing for a long time. So we have used future perfect continuous tense here. And one more notable thing is that for future continuous, future perfect and future perfect continuous, keywords are the same. According to the situation, we can choose the tense form of the verb. Thank you. Thank you for watching.